Hello. Welcome to today's experiment. Today, you're going to do the experiment on testing the hardness of different metals using Rockwell Hardness Tester. The Rockwell Hardness Test is generally a non-destructive test performed on samples when it is necessary to determine how hard a material is. Hugh M. Rockwell and Stanley P. Rockwell co-invented the first tester, and a patent was granted in 1919. The Rockwell Hardness Test is generally considered easier to perform compared to other methods such as Vickers or Brunel. Rockwell Hardness Testing Machine essentially consists of the following. 1. A supporting table for placing the specimen. 2. A hand wheel to raise or lower the supporting table. 3. A switch to change between loads. 4. A lever to load and unload the major loads. 5. A Rockwell ball indenter, which is a hardened steel ball. 6. A Rockwell cone indenter, which is a diamond cone of 120 degrees. 7. A dial that provides the reading of hardness number. 8. An instruction plate that provide information about the different scales to be used for different metals and the corresponding load to be applied for those. The indenter is forced into the surface of a test piece in two steps. Initially, a minor load of 10 kg is applied to a penetrator, causing an indentation D1 in the test specimen. Application of minor load eliminates backlash in low terrain and causes indenter to break through surface roughness, contributing to accuracy in test. With minor load still operating, major load is added according to the scale mentioned in the machine. The application of major load increases the depth of penetration. Some materials show considerable time-dependent plasticity. The duration of application of major load shall be neither less than 10 seconds nor greater than 15 seconds. Then the major load is removed with the minor load is still acting. This operation results in the partial recovery in the depth of indentation. Rockwell hardness test has the following step in common for all the materials. Step 1. Place the material to be tested on the supporting table. Step 2. Load an initial force. For Rockwell hardness test, the initial test force is 10 kgf. Step 3. Set the main load referenced from the hardness scale given. Step 4. Leave the main load for a dwell time sufficient for indentation to come to a halt. Step 5. Release the load. The Rockwell value will typically display on the dial. Now, let us start with finding the Rockwell hardness values for each material one by one. First, let us start with aluminium. Before placing the test piece, we have to fix the indenter on the machine. To find which indenter to use, let us look at the hardness scale given. Here, we can see that for aluminum, it's given as ball indenter with a load of 100 kgf. So now, let us place the test piece on the supporting table. Now, rotate the hand wheel until the tip of the ball indenter touches the test piece, and the dial reaches B0 on the bigger needle, and 3 on the smaller needle, which means 10 kg of minor load is applied on the test piece. Now, initialize the load of 100 kgf using the switch given. Push the lever towards the load side gently, and leave the main load for a dwell time, sufficient for indentation to come to a halt. Now, pull the lever back to unload position. Look at the dial, and note down the reading. Repeat the same process 3 times for each material, and take down the values. While testing the specimen, make sure that the indentation should not be made nearer to the edge of the specimen to avoid unnecessary concentration of stresses. The spacing between the two adjacent impressions should be at least 3 times the diameter of indentation. Rapid rate of applying load to the specimen should be avoided. Load applied on the ball may rise a little because of its sudden action. Also, rapidly applied load will restrict plastic flow of a material, which produces effect on size of indentation. Now, we can clearly see the indentation formed on the surface of the test piece. The values we got during indentation are taken, and mean value is found out to be 73 for aluminium. Similarly, using ball indenter, we found out the mean hardness value of copper and cast iron were 71 and 98.66 respectively. Now, let us find the hardness of stainless steel using diamond indenter. For a diamond indenter, it's the C scale and the readings of the black dial has to be taken. And for ball indenter, it's the B scale and the reading of the red dial has to be considered. First, let's replace the ball indenter with the diamond indenter. Now, let's place the test piece of stainless steel on the supporting table. Now, rotate the hand wheel until the tip of the diamond indenter touches the test piece. And the dial reaches 0 on black dial with the bigger needle, and 3 on the smaller needle. Which means 10 kilograms of minor load is applied on the test piece. According to the Rockwell hardness scale given on the machine, for stainless steel a load of 150 kgf has to be applied. Now initialize the load of 150 kgf using the switch given. Push the lever towards the load side gently, and leave the main load for a dwell time sufficient for indentation to come to a halt. Now, pull the lever back to unload position. Look at the dial, and note down the reading. Now, let us take two more trails for the same test piece. The dial shows the second trial reading as 16. The third trial reading is 19 as shown on the dial. Now, we can clearly see the cone-shaped indentation formed on the surface of the test piece. So now, calculating the mean hardness value for stainless steel, we found it to be 16.33. Similarly, using diamond indenter, we found out the mean hardness value of mild steel to be 14.33. HRC represents the hardness number on the Rockwell C scale, while HRB represents the hardness number on the Rockwell B scale. So, from the mean values of the observation table, let us conclude to the final results. The higher the Rockwell hardness number, the harder the material, but only relative to other numbers within a given scale. From this table, we can conclude that on the B scale, cast iron is harder compared to copper and aluminium. And on the C scale, stainless steel is harder compared to mild steel. That's all for today. This video was created by Step and Digi. Thanks for watching this video. We will meet you in another experiment. Until then, goodbye.